you come to me, I'll make it so you never leave. Can you rock with me? Hey YouTube, it's Taylor. I am back with another video. So this video, I'm basically going to be doing a basically step-by-step on how to successfully beat your face. And this is going to be for beginners. So if you want to get into makeup, if you know a little bit, but you want to know more, you want to be more knowledgeable, this is the video you need to be watching. this is going to be a talk through. I'm going to be very in-depth. I'm going to be very in-depth so that you guys know basically how to do it, why you're doing it, and all that great stuff. So you want to start with a fresh, clean face. So I just washed my face. I use African black soap and raw shea butter soap, and I got them from GNC. It's the Shea Moisture ones, and I mix them, wash my face, rinse it. So now to moisturize my face, the first thing I use is my Epiduo, and I love this stuff. I've been using this for a really long time. It helps with my acne. It helps with, like, you only need like this much. You don't even need this much, but it just helps with like incoming acne and all, you know, acne that you already have on your face. And I just place it mostly in my T-zone because that's where I break out the most. So now to moisturize my face, I'm using my Pure Rosehip Seed Oil. It's like a little dropper, and I do like 5 to 6 drops. I mean, it's up to you. And it looks like that, and then I just put it all over my face. My lips get dry really quick, so I got some trusty Carmex. I'm just going to put it all over my lips. Okay, so now I am moisturizing everything. So now we can get into applying the makeup. So the first thing that I like to do my eyebrows. So for my eyebrows, this is the brush I'm using. I just picked this up from the beauty supply store. This is the Ardell eyebrow brush. I mean, it has like the slanted angled brush and then a spoolie on the other end. So very good. So yeah, we're gonna get into the brows. So what I want to do, well, what you want to do, you want to do your eyebrows first. I prefer this. It's up to you, but I prefer to do my eyebrows first just because it's easier in my opinion. So I'm going to get my Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in the color chocolate. I just got a new one, so it's brand new. Like, I have not opened it yet. Gonna get your angled brush and you're just going to fill in your brows. If you want to know exactly like the ins and out on how to do your brows, I have a brow tutorial already up, so definitely check that out. I can put the link in the description box. And it's mainly for girls with thicker brows because I do have thick brows, so now my eyebrows are filled in. So now to clean them up, I'm going to use concealer. So this is my Graftobian HD Glimmer Cream set. Why did I say it like that? So I'm using this color right here. This is Midnight Marigold. And yeah, I'm just going to clean up my brows. And I'm using this straight brush like this. You don't necessarily have to use a shade that's lighter than your skin tone. If you don't want that more highlighted look, more extra kind of look, then you can use a concealer or foundation that's your shade. It's up to you. So I'm just going to highlight my brows and I think I like how your body feels.
you're kissing me. Oh, baby, when you're loving me. I can't describe what I think I like how your body feels next to me. Oh, baby, when you're kissing me. Oh, baby, when you're loving me. I can't describe what I want to do to you tonight. Oh, baby, when you come to me, I'll make it so you never leave.
Okay, so now my eyebrows are nice and done and concealed. They were popping or whatever. So now I'm going to get my NYX Control Freak brow gel, and I'm just going to run the gel through my brows so that they do not move. Okay, so now my brows are nice and set and everything. So now we're going to move on to the eyes. So this is going to be like everything beginner. Like, this is going to be eyeshadow 101, because I know a lot of people ask me like how to do eyeshadow and different steps and things like that. So I'm going to basically walk you through how to do a successful eyeshadow look. So first, what you want to have, you want to obviously have a palette. I'm going to use the Morphe 350, because it's a very neutral, warm, basic palette, and I think that a lot of the colors you can find anywhere, even if you don't have the palette. They have a lot of similar colors and things like that. So yeah, what it looks like. It's very pretty. You can do anything with this palette, to be honest. Yeah, so first I'm going to get a primer. So you always want to have a primer. A primer will basically make sure that your eyeshadow stays in place. The primer that I use is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Eyeshadow Primer. This is the best primer I have ever used. Well, this is the only primer I've ever used, but I will never, like, try anything else. Like, never, ever. Like, this stuff is amazing. Like, if you have oily lids, your lids will not get oily. There will be no transferring, nothing, the whole time you are wearing your makeup. I promise you, like, this stuff, it's that. It's like that. So, yeah. So, my hands are ashy. This is so out of track. You want to get this. If you don't have this, you can get this from Walmart. It's totally inexpensive. There's a lot of primers that are really expensive, but this one is not. So I definitely recommend it. If you don't want to use this, you can use just concealer and a translucent powder to set it. Whichever works for you. I'm going to get some of it. You don't need a lot. I'm just going to put this much. I'm going to put it on my eye, and you just want to spread it. When you first get it, it's going to be a little weird because you're like, okay, what's going on? But it dries very quick. Literally, once you spread it, it's dry. So you want to kind of work really quick with it. Definitely some advice you would like to have. Oh, now that I have the primer on my eyelids, I'm going to get my Ben Nye Camo Powder. And I'm just going to set it with that so that the eyeshadows that I place on my eye are nice and smooth.
I think I like how your body feels next to me. Oh, baby, when you're kissing me. Oh, baby, when you're loving me. I can't describe what I want to do to you tonight. Oh, baby, when you come to me, I'll make it so you know.
Okay, so once your eyeshadow is set, you can start your eyeshadow. I said, that doesn't make sense. Once your primer is set, you could start your eyeshadow. Definitely recommend for beginners BH Cosmetics or Coastal Scents for like beginner brush sets, or just brush sets period, because they're very cheap. They always have sales and they're really nice. So this one, this particular brush is my favorite. This is from Coastal Scents, $2.99. This is like the Pro Blending Fluff, and it's very fluffy. I've been using it a couple times, and I just washed it. I wash all my brushes, so everything is clean. Make sure you guys clean your brushes. It prevents acne also. So first, what we're going to do, we're going to start with a transition color. You always want to start with the transition, because that is the color that all of your other shadows are going to fall into. You want like your shadows to have a nice gradient effect. So you have like, you know, nice and light, warm, and then you go down to like the dark and you go to the light, you know, stuff like that. Cause it's, you know, this is a beginner. So, you know, you want to go with the basics. So with this particular set, I personally like with brown skin, I feel like warm transition colors are very pretty and very appealing to your eye. So I like to go in with these four colors right here. So I just dab in them, and I'm not going to do the dance because that's corny. Yeah, so I'm going to just dab in each one. And then you want to go in your crease and above your crease. So I like to go above my crease and kind of in it when I first do my transition color, and I like to build on it just so you get like the true color. So you want to start like this, and you also want to have a light hand. Don't have your hand all the way like this because the product will kind of be very harsh. It'll go on really harsh. So you want to have your hand like kind of like basically just holding the end and just sweeping it very gently. It makes blending a lot easier. Okay, so now the transition color has been added. You can add more if you would like, or you know, leave it. I personally like to build on it just so you can get, you know, the true color, just so, I don't know, I just always build on it. Okay, so now that you've applied your transition color, now it's time for your crease color. So usually the color that goes in your crease is a little bit darker. It can be like a dark brown. Sometimes it could be black. It depends on what color you want. So we're gonna go with a dark brown. So I'm gonna go into this color. So sometimes it depends. You can use the same brush or go into a different brush. For the sake of the video, I'm gonna use a different brush. So I'm gonna get another blending brush. So this is also from Coastal Scents. This is just a simple blending brush. It's really nice. I like it. And I'm going to just go into the color. Make sure you have a very light hand. And you want to just sweep it right in the crease. Your crease is, when you open your eyes, that kind of right there. So that's where you want to place it.
Just a friend, oh baby, I can't pretend, oh baby, I'm so far in, but I don't mind as long as I could have you in my life, oh baby, I'm
so. Okay, so now that I applied it, I did it very subtle. You could have a more, I just want it to be very subtle and beginner friendly. So once you place the dark brown, now you want to go back into your transition and blend it out to make sure that there's no harsh lines or anything. You want everything to just go into each other smoothly, if that makes any sense. So I'm just going to blend right where that line is and just blend it out, just like that. So now we're going to go into the lid color. So usually your lid color can be a shimmery color, it could be a light matte shade, it could be whatever. For the sake of this video, I'm just going to do just a simple shimmery color, gold or whatever. So I'm going to mix this kind of orangey coppery shimmery shade and mix it with this one and this one and this one. I'm gonna just mix them all and just place it on my lid. A way to make your shadows more pigmented, you could spray it with Fix Plus spray, or like a, you could spray it with water, any setting spray, anything like that to get it more pigmented, you could use that. So what I want to do, I'm going to spray the brush. Once you get it on your brush, you're just going to just go on your lid. Okay, so now that your lid color is applied, now you want to go back into the dark brown shade and you want to blend out the edges. If I can handle you as just a friend, oh baby, I can't pretend, oh baby, I'm so far in, but I don't mind as long as I could have you in my life, oh baby, I'm... You want to go back into your transition color and blend out the dark brown. So it's kind of like going back and forth. Once you add a color, you blend it, then blend the other one, and then add another one, and just kind of, it's kind of going back and forth. It seems like a lot, but once you get the hang of it, it can be really easy. Okay, so if you would like, you can leave it just like this, and you know, that'll be it. But I personally like to add more dimension to my eye, especially when I'm working with like browns and stuff. I like to add a black. It adds more dimension to your eye and it just gives you a whole different type of look. So I'm going to go into another palette and use a matte black shade. Go into my Morphe 35P and just use this matte black shade. Also going to use this blending brush, also from Coastal Scents. Really great. I'm going to go into the black and you want to just go on your outer corner. Just like that. I can't describe what I want to do to you tonight. Oh baby, when you come to me, I'll make it so you never leave. So the black is added and you see it just gives you a whole different look. So now once you've added the black, I just want to blend this out a little bit more. And now I'm going to go back into the dark brown, blend out the black, and go into the transition color and blend that out. So literally that easy, y'all. And the key is also, like, the main thing that you want to take from this, blend your heart out. Not even with just eyeshadow, just with everything, you want to blend. Like, you want to make sure everything is nice and seamless, no harsh lines, all of that. So I'm going back into the dark brown and just going right above the black. You just want to blend that out. You as just a friend, oh baby, I can't pretend, oh baby, I'm so far in, but I don't mind as long as I could have you in my life, oh baby, I'm satisfied, even if you're not just mine. Can you rock with me? Oh baby, stop for me. Can you take it to the top of me? I just wanna love you. Alright, so now everything is nice and blended. So now what you want to do, you want to highlight your brow bone. Sometimes I do this, sometimes I don't, but it just adds more of a highlighted look. It kind of just ties everything in. So I'm just going to use the same exact colors that I used to put on my lid, and I'm just going to just place them on my brow bone. So we're not going to complete the eyes. Now we're going to move on to the face. So for the face, you always want to have a great primer. I feel like primer definitely determines how well your makeup is going to turn out. So this is the Cover Effects Mattifying Primer with the Anti-Acne Treatment. This is really great for oily skin. Again, I have oily skin, very oily skin. So if you have like dry skin or combination, you might not really be able to use. You could follow this tutorial, but as far as the products that I'm using, you might not want to use them. Just saying. So it's kind of clear, and I'm just going to place it all over my face, but mainly in my T-zone because that's where I get the most oily. So now that I'm finished with applying my primer, I'm now going to use my foundation. So the foundation that I've been using lately is the Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation in the color R530. This is the liquid form. I have the stick, but I ran out. Like, I have like a little bit, like I have to scrape it out. So I haven't been using it, but this is just as good. So yeah. So one thing that I'm going to do, this is something that I probably wouldn't do as a beginner, but I really want to use it. Like, I really want to use it. So I'm gonna just use it. So this is my Peter Thomas Roth 24 karat gold pure luxury lift and firm prism cream. It's a long name, but this is what it looks like. Like, this packaging is so pretty. Like, I love this. I used this as well in the summer, and I mixed it with my foundation, and my skin was flawless. So I had to get the actual bottle, like the big bottle. It's not really big, but I had to get the normal size. And all you have to do is basically mix it in with your foundation. But yeah. So I'm going to just place it on my hand. And then I'm going to just mix it in with my foundation. Okay. So also what you want to use a damp sponge, beauty blender, Real Techniques beauty sponge, any of that, use it. Make sure it's damp because you'll get a better application. Now my beauty blender is damp, and I'm just going to kind of go into it and just mix it up. And just blend it into my skin. My foundation and everything is on. So now moving on to highlighting. So now I'm going to go back into my Graftovian HD Glamour cream, and I'm going to use this concealer. When you're highlighting, you want to highlight under your eyes. So I'm not going to do as extra as I would usually do, just for the sake of this video. So you want to just go under your eyes. You want to kind of make like triangles, and if you've already done your eyeshadow, you kind of want to kind of cut it like right there, just so you have a more precise look. Matter of fact, I'm not gonna hold back. Like, I'm gonna just do what I usually do, just walk y'all through the steps. Because I'm sure y'all want to be me, so. Alright, so when you're contour your nose according to your nose shape. So my personal nose shape, I have a kind of a wider nose. So to make my nose really snatched, I kind of cut, not really cut, but when I'm doing my concealer, I kind of cut the side of my nostrils a little bit, kind of go down and cut them, just so when I'm contouring, it kind of snatches my nose. Okay, so now you could do your Cupid's bow, and I usually like, lately I've just been highlighting the whole thing, like my whole upper lip. On this side, I'm not gonna really cut my nose, because I have my nose piercing and it's still kind of in the healing process, so I'm not really gonna do that side, but by all means you can as well, if you would like. And then I'm just gonna go on my forehead. This is usually where the light will hit, so that's why you're highlighting it. And then the bridge of my nose.
See, I don't know if I can handle you as just a friend. Oh, baby, I can't pretend. Oh, baby, I'm so far in. But I don't mind as long.
You're going to just blend it out. What I usually do, I blend out the edges first. And then blend like the inner area. Okay, so now that that is blended in, now I'm going to bake. So I'm using my airspun powder and I'm mixing it with my Benai camo powder. The reason I mix is because it's like, it gives me the perfect shade. Airspun powder is very light, and for my skin tone, it'll give me flashback. I don't care how, they always say translucent. It's not that translucent because it will give me flashback. I know, I've tried it. It gives me flashback. So when I mix it with the Benai, it's more my skin tone, so it kind of tones it down and it makes the perfect shade for me, so I always use that. So this is what it looks like mixed, and I just go into it with my beauty blender and just set all the places I concealed. I don't bake for a long time, so now I'm just going to brush it off with this brush from BH Cosmetics. So now you are nice and set. So now we're going to move on to contouring. The main purpose is to kind of chisel your face to make your face more slim, basically just to slim down your face to give the illusion that you have a more structured face, bone structure, whatever. So the thing that I use my Ruby Kisses 3D Face Creator in the color level 16. I got some more. So I'm going to go in both of these shades. This shade is darker than this one, but when I mix them, they're really nice. So I'm going to just use this brush and I'm going to carve out my cheeks. So when you contour, you want to carve out your cheeks so that your face is real snatched, like you haven't eaten in a few days, like real snatched. And then you want to carve out your forehead, just, you know, to make it look smaller. You want to carve out your nose so that it looks smaller, and your jawline to get that double chin to, you know, disappear. So I'm going to just go into each of them, and this is cream. Cream contouring is easy. It's for beginner, it might be a little bit difficult. I don't think it's difficult. It's just on how you blend. You have to blend this. Like when you're cream contouring, you really need to blend really good. So I set with a powder. So if you just want to use powder, you can like look at it when I like set it. That makes any sense. So I'm gonna cream contour, and then I'm a powder contour if that makes any sense. Yeah, I'm going to cream contour, then powder, because I use the powder to set the cream. So, yeah, so you can use do whichever way you want. So you want to kind of suck your cheek in. And do it like that. And then also, when you cream contour, you want to do, you know, carve out your jawline, and you want to blend upwards. Just like that. Blending your contour, you want to go in a circular motion like that. So you want to pat, but go in circular motions, and that helps blend everything out. Okay, so now that we are all nice and bronzed and contoured and everything, so now I'm going to set the contour. So if you're not really into powder contouring, I mean cream contouring, then you can definitely use powder. So I'm going to go back into my 350 using the dark brown shade. And I'm just going to go into it with this brush, and I'm just going to go exactly where I contoured with the cream, and I'm just going to set it. But like I said again, if you don't want a cream contour, look at how I do the powder contour, so you know how to do it. So usually I get a little bit on my brush, and I like to go in circular motions just how I was blending. So you want to start here. You want to kind of go up into your hairline. Please blend in your hairline. Like, your edges will get messed up, but that's why you do your makeup first and then your edges and your hair. Because you need to get up into your hairline when you are contouring and blending and all of that stuff. To cut my contour, and basically the point is just to kind of chisel your face more, because sometimes you can, like, you know, some features kind of get lost when you're contouring. So just to kind of more accentuate, like, your jawline and stuff like that, your cheekbones, you can do this. And this is optional, you don't have to do this, but if you want BB, I suggest you do it. I mean, why not? So you want to get this much. I mean, you can use a little bit less or a little bit more. I mean, it's up to you. And you want to suck in your cheeks and go under your contour. So just like this. And you want to start from, like, your ear and bring it way down. And just brush it. I don't feel the need to bake under it, so I just brush it instantly and make sure I blend it in with my contour, just so it, you know, looks nice. You don't want it too harsh, because then you're gonna look real crazy. Now we're almost done, y'all. Almost done. So now moving on to blush. I'm going to use this blush from my Avon Ultimate Mega Palette. And I'm just going to go in with this brush from BH Cosmetics. And you just want to put it on your cheeks. Alright, so now we are going to finish the eyes. So now we're going to go back to the 350. So I'm going to get this dark brown shade. And you want to get a smaller, precise brush. I'm using this brush. I think it kind of sunk in. I don't know how, but that's neither here nor there. So, matter of fact, I'm going to use this kind of brownish, reddish color. And I'm going to place that on my lower lash line. I think I like how your body feels next to me.
Oh baby, when you're kissing me. Oh baby, when you're loving me. I can't describe.
Okay, and then you want to highlight your inner corner. You can use the same color you used to highlight your brow bone. So I'm going to use this kind of, I don't know what kind of brush this is called, but I'm just going to go into each of the colors and just place it on my inner corner. Okay, so now you want to get like a black pencil. You can use white. I use white because it opens up your eyes and makes your eyes more bright. You appear more awake. But for this, I'm going to use black. You can use eyebrow pencil, black eye pencil, eyeshadow, whatever. And I'm going to use this Ruby Kisses Go Brow Eyebrow Pencil. It's in the color black, but I really don't like it for my eyebrow, so I'm going to just use it as eyeliner for my lower lash line. For mascara, I'm using this NYX Waterproof Mascara, the Le Chic Flick mascara, and I'm just going to go on my lower lash line, do my lower lashes and my upper lashes to prepare for falsies. Okay, so now time for lashes. I'm going to show you how to apply your lashes, basically, because I know also with beginners, you know, a lot of people might think that it's, well, might see that it's like really hard. So I'm going to show y'all exactly how to do it. So the lashes I'm using are the Southern Beauty Mink Lashes. These are either in this, I think these are in the style Evelyn. And I am using this I Envy Kiss Strip Lash Adhesive in the color black. I don't like this one. This is not what I usually use. I usually use the Duo, but the beauty supply store that I went to didn't have it, so I just picked this up because I need lash glue. So I was like, this is just gonna have to work. So yeah, so also what you want to use, tweezers. For people that this is like their first time using lashes, tweezers really help, or like a lash applicator. It really helps just putting them on and placing them properly. Yeah, so first we grab the tweezers. You just want to dip it. Just dip the band. You don't want to put too much. And then if it's too much, just, yeah. Your hand is a canvas, honestly, so use your hand. There's nothing that a makeup wipe can't fix. So it's going to look just like that. And then you're just going to let it get a little tacky. I let my glue get tacky. I'm going to move on to my highlight. So I personally like to use a lot of highlighters, but if you're a beginner, you don't have to. So I think for the sake of this video, I'm gonna use one. Okay, I'm gonna use one, well, two, because yeah. So the one that I'm using, this one is the color Pop Super Shock Cheek in the color Wisp. This is a really, it's very thick and creamy. I really like it, but
I only use it for my nose and my Cupid's bow. I feel like it's easier that way. I tried putting it on my cheeks before, and I just don't like the way it looks. So I'm going to use this, and you want to just get a little bit. It's really pigmented. It's really pretty. And I just put it on the tip of my nose and the bridge of my nose. And then you could just use another finger, or you can use a brush if you want, and I just blend it out. So the glue is actually pretty tacky. So once the glue is tacky, sticky or whatever, you want to just put them. So you want to get your lash. I'm going to get close into the camera. You want to first look down when you're applying it. Get a mirror and look down. It'll be a lot easier. Sorry for the outside noise. And then you want to go in first. You want to get it in the middle. And then get the edges. And stick it. Super easy. Then you want to get your other one. You just want to do the same exact thing. Get it in the middle, and then just okay, and then you successfully put on some lashes. This is the main highlighter that I will be using, the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Press in the color Topaz. This has lasted me literally 2 years, and it's still some in there. There's stuff around the edges. I need to order a new one because, yeah. But I'm still going to use it because it's my favorite. Like, I love this. This is probably like something I will always buy and always make sure I have money for. I think I might buy two. So I'm going to just attempt to spray it with this little bit of Fix Plus that I have. And then I'm going to apply it with my fan brush. You always want to get like the highest points of your face. So when you smile, your cheekbones, like the top of your cheekbones and your, well, a lot of people don't do their forehead, but I like to do my forehead, but for the sake of this video, I won't do my forehead. And your Cupid's bow, nose, and your chin. So I'm going to do just that. So you just want to swirl it around like so. And I think when you spray it with your Fix Plus, it kind of, I don't know, it makes it more pigmented. And I don't know, I just always do it. And then you just want to place it. Finish the face. So now we're going to move on to the lips. So the lips, I want to do something very neutral but real cute. So this is Max Lip Pencil in Bittersweet, and I'm just gonna line my lips. I'll make it so you never, baby, can you rock with me? Okay, so now that I line my lips, I'm going to use the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the color London. And I'm going to just place this right in the middle. I'm going to go into the NYX Butter Lipstick in the color Sugar Wafer. And I'm just going to place that like a little bit on the, in the middle. Okay, so I want it to be like a gloss, so I'm going to use the this clear lip gloss, this Laugh Out Loud lip gloss by Nana Coco. It's clear. It's, well, white camellia. And this is from the beauty supply store. And then I'm just gonna place this right on top.
Oh baby, I can't pretend. Oh baby, I'm so far in. But I don't mind as long as I could have you in my life. Oh baby, I'm satisfied. Even
okay, and now to set my face, I'm going to use the Urban Decay D-Slick makeup setting spray. It's oil control. And I just got this, so we'll see how it is. So okay, I'm just gonna spray it on my face. Okay. All right, guys. So this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that this was beginner friendly. I'm really trying to do like beginner things, but this was pretty simple, so I hope you guys got it. If there are any other beginner looks, anything that you guys want me to show you guys how to do, let me know and I'll get to it. But yeah, I really enjoyed filming this look. I like the way that it turned out. So if you could please like, rate, comment, subscribe, all that great stuff. Follow me on my social media handles, which will be in the description box. And yeah, I will see y'all in my next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Love y'all. Have a great one.